Hi guys, Eva here. Hope you're all having a great day. I just wanted to hop on Facebook Live really quickly to answer a very common question that I've been getting from so many of you regarding sleep and the holiday season because Hanukkah started and it's going to be Christmas soon, and many of you are planning vacations and traveling and visiting family, and you anticipate, you know, that your little one's routine is going to be off and they're not going to be sleeping at home. They'll be sleeping in a strange environment, and you all want to know what can you do to maintain your little one's wickedly awesome sleep. So, here are my top three tips for you when it comes to sleep and the holiday season. So, tip number one is that you want to do your best to recreate your little one's sleep environment as much as you can while you're away. So, if your little one sleeps in a sleep sack, bring that sleep sack with you. Bring the white noise machine with you that your little one might sleep with at night. Bring your little one's teddy bear, stuffed bunny, blanket, whatever comfort toys that he usually sleeps with. If there's a special good night book or music that you listen to, a song that you listen to, bring all of that with you so that you can recreate your environment and your routine as much as possible, which is going to be very familiar and comforting to your little one while he learns how to settle in this different new environment. And then, of course, if your little one is usually sleeping in her own room, do your best to ensure that your accommodations, wherever you're sleeping, has a separate space for your little one to sleep in. Because if she's not used to sleeping in the same room as you, then you don't want her potentially waking up, getting distracted by you, seeing you right there, and then waking up more frequently at night as a result. So I know this isn't always feasible, but do the best you can. So that's tip number one. Tip number two is do the best you can to protect your little one's naps and their schedule as much as possible. So, with some flexibility, of course. So, obviously, if you're on vacation and you want to be out for the majority of the day, then having your little one take three naps a day or even two naps a day in a crib in your hotel or Airbnb might not be realistic. But perhaps what might be realistic is for your little one to take the morning nap in the crib in your hotel or Airbnb and then nap on the go throughout the rest of the day. So this isn't something that you would ordinarily be doing when you're at home, but perhaps when you're away and your little one is sleeping, you know, really well, you can often get away with some of that flexibility. So you don't want to throw the entire schedule and routine out the window because you're likely going to end up throwing their nighttime sleep out the window, and you could end up having a really cranky baby or toddler on your hands. But if you need to be a little bit flexible with where they are sleeping, that is totally, totally fine. So that's tip number two. And then tip number three is when you get back home and you have found that maybe you created some habits that you don't necessarily want in the long run, get your baby or your toddler back on their previous routine and previous set of habits as quickly as possible. So if there was a time change, give yourself a few days to adjust to, you know, the new time zone that you're back in, and then don't wait. If you need to do some re-sleep training, get on it immediately. If your little one's schedule went out the door, get them back on their schedule as quickly as you can so that you can get everyone's sleep back as quickly as you can. So I hope that this was helpful and that you all have a wonderful day and a wonderful holiday season. Take care. Have a good day.